May we request the parents and godparents to kindly stand beside Mara and Patrick as witnesses to this ceremony. Dearly beloved Mara and Patrick, you have come together to seal your love for each other through the sacrament of matrimony. In the presence of the Church, the people of God, I now ask you to state your intentions. Mara, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your husband?
Yes, Father.
Patrick, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your wife?
Yes, Father.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the laws of Christ and His Church?
Yes, Father.
Mara and Patrick, since it is your intention to enter into holy matrimony, please join your right hands and express your intention before God and His Church.
I, Mara, take you, Patrick, for my lawful husband. According to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church, I give myself to you as your wife, and I accept you as my lawful husband. To my dearest Pat, I remember first seeing you and thinking, hey, this guy's kinda cute. But as you know, I was warned by many of your colorful past. But heck, I thought, I always wanted to try being the girl who played the player, so I agreed to go out with you. After a month or so into dating, I started falling for you. So I remember sitting you down and telling you I no longer wanted us to see each other. But you stopped me with the most sincere eyes I've seen and said, please no, I promise I'll make it worth it. Years later, I'd often want to give up when we were long distance. But you'd often hold on tightly to me and tell me, no, I promise I'll make it worth it. You truly have made it worth it, Pat. You have shown me a love so genuine and unconditional. Even despite the difficult past few months we've had, the goodness in your heart always wins me over. I promise from this day forward to never give up on us. When times get tough, I promise to be the one to tell you this is all worth it. Truth is, very early on, I already knew you were the one for me. Because from the start, loving you has felt so natural. Yes, we're both not perfect, and we often disagree. But you have allowed me to be me. You have made me feel a level of joy and love I never even knew existed. Thank you for choosing to take care of me for the rest of our lives. Thank you for making me feel beautiful every single day, legs and all. Thank you for believing in me when I don't believe in myself. I truly believe that you are living proof that God loves me and He will take care of me even when I doubt His plans and His ways. In your embrace, I feel most safe, protected, and loved. You've seen me in my worst and you've stood by me and guided me. You've given me strength I never knew I had inside and taught me to see the beauty and joy in life. I promise to take care of you, our future children, and take care of what we have. I promise to prioritize you and our family. I promise to continue to be your number one fan and always cheer for you in every basketball game I watch. And even if you play too rough for my comfort, I promise to take care of you even if you come home with broken bones. Because I know giving it your all is the only way you know how to live life. And for that, I love you even more. I promise to forever admire and respect you. I've seen how our small dreams have both failed and succeeded over the years. But through it all, I am prouder to be with you because of your crazy optimism. I know I can get too opinionated at times, but I promise to trust you and listen to you even when it's hardest. I know some days will be ugly, and I know we'll have scream fests. But I promise to always say sorry first. I promise to listen and understand you before jumping into conclusions. And every day, I promise to choose to love you again and again. The sungit you, the messy you, the forever forgetful and absent-minded you. I may never be able to fully express how much I love you in words, but I hope you feel it in my actions. I promise to live true to the saying, wherever you go, I shall go. Your dreams shall be mine, because I choose you. So wherever you are, that's where my home will be. I promise to support you always because I believe so much in you. I believe you have the ability to do great things, things that will change the world for the better, just as you have changed mine. You amaze me every day, and I cannot wait for you to teach our future children everything that you are. You have truly made everything worth it, Pat. You are my soulmate, and I love you more than you know, but I promise to show you every single day just how much.
I, Patrick, take you, Mara, for my lawful wife, according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church. I give myself to you as your husband, and I accept you as my lawful wife. It's been incredibly difficult to put into words what I wanted to say to you today, my love. But it all comes down to just two things for me. Nothing more, nothing less. First, how unimaginably thankful I am to God to have you in my life. And second, that starting today, I make it my life's mission to look after you, to prioritize our relationship above anything else, to make a commitment towards making this work. First is about gratitude. Ever since I was young, my mom would say to me, Pat, you're so lucky. Don't forget to thank God for your blessings. Looking back, I don't think I ever fully appreciated the gravity of her words. Maybe because I would subconsciously reason out that whatever I got was a result of my own actions and not anyone else's. I felt I deserved it. But in all honesty, I never deserved you. Yet somehow, God chose you for me, and here we are today. You are, without question, life's greatest gift. And like any gift, the only thing you can really do is accept it and be thankful to him and thankful to you. Thank you for taking the ultimate leap of faith, for entrusting your life to me, even before I could say it was mine to take. Though the road ahead was not always clear, you called shotgun and said, let's do this. Thank you for always expecting more out of me. Your endless belief in me is as humbling as it is uplifting. Thank you for teaching me what it means to be a real man and then challenging me to become one. Thank you for showing me what the faces of humility, service, loyalty, and sacrifice look like when I see them in you day in and day out. Thank you for loving me even during the times I was not very easy to love. Second is about commitment. I promise to remind you every morning how beautiful you are, just as I have for the past 4 years. I promise that you'll never have to sleep with the lights on again, because I'll be right there beside you every night. I promise to continue being both your fiercest supporter and loudest critic, but more importantly, develop the skill to know which one you need me to be at that moment. I promise to not keep count of how many times someone was right or someone was wrong, but only remember that each time someone got hurt. And saying sorry is another way of saying, I love you more than I care about winning this fight. Speaking of fights, I promise to resolve our arguments without storming off and with minimal damage to our furniture. It's an inside joke. I promise to never let vanity, pride, and personal ambition come in the way of what's right for our family. I promise to choose the difficult right over the easy wrong. I promise to keep your life exciting. For just as the opposite of love is not hate, but indifference, the opposite of happiness is boredom. Therefore, I promise to take you on the greatest adventures of your life, whether it is to be explored in distant countries or merely discovered in the calm everydayness of life. I promise that while the passage of years may take many things away from us, it will never dull the flames of our romance. I promise you candlelit dinners on Fridays, movie dates on Saturdays, bike rides on Sundays, and nonstop hugs and kisses all the days in between. And even when we are 50, we will still go outside to dance in the rain. Life is too short to waste it on something mediocre, especially love. A line from an old movie goes, "Today, I commit to making this love extraordinary. So take my hand, sweetheart. Don't be afraid. The very best is yet to come."
Mara and Patrick, you have declared your consent before God and His people. May the Lord fill you with abundant blessings and provide you with the strength necessary to be faithful in love to God and to each other. Now, please say together,
"Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and one soul from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part."
And I, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The parents and sponsors may now be seated.
We shall now bless the array and the rings.
May we call on our array and ring bearers, Inigo and Miguel, to come forward with the array and rings.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven,
who made heaven and earth.
Lord, bless these rings, so that Mara and Patrick may always be reminded of your undivided love for them and their undivided love for each other. May they live in mutual love and in unbroken loyalty until the end of time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mara, wear this ring as a sign of my unconditional love and fidelity to you, and as a promise of my care, trust, and responsibility for you and our family, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Patrick, wear this ring as a sign of my unconditional love and fidelity to you, and as a promise of my care, trust, and responsibility for you and for our family. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, bless this array, which come from your bountiful love. Grant Mara and Patrick not only the sufficiency of material possessions, but also the generosity to share this especially with those in need, so that as members of the Church, they can be responsible stewards of your gifts for a more humane and just society, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mara, I give you these array as a pledge of my total dedication to your welfare and that of our family. May the sharing of all that we have and all that we are, lead us to seek and work for the good of the bigger community. This is my offering, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Patrick, I accept these are with love and gratitude, and I promise to be your fellow steward of God's blessings.
May we now call our Bible bearer, Gabo, to come forward with the Bible.
All scripture comes from the breath of God and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, training in righteousness, so that man and woman of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. Mara and Patrick, receive this Holy Bible to remind you that human beings do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Feed your hearts, your minds, and your spirits with the eternal words of life, which come to us from God, so that you and your children may drink from the same spiritual wealth and live.
We accept this Holy Bible as God's word to guide us through our lives. We commit ourselves to discerning what God wants of us as individuals and as a couple, and to acting on it in order to help extend God's reign on earth. We declare this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
May I now invite everybody to stand up and join me in prayer for Mara and Patrick. I request you to extend both hands towards Mara and Patrick. Gracious God, we thank you for the gift of Mara and Patrick and for uniting them in holy matrimony. We pray that as they journey together on this earth, they will remain faithful to you and to each other and to their responsibility to the bigger community. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Patrick and Mara are now husband and wife. Please give them a round of applause.
Let us call on God, who knows our needs. Confident of his care and concern, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that all our bishops and clergy, through the leadership of Pope Francis and the entire community of believers, may be faithful to your word and live Eucharistic lives of service in the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Filipino people, may we not lose important spiritual and human values in the struggle for development. May we go beyond our prejudices and differences and grow in the spirit of brotherhood to witness to God's kingdom here on earth. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our country and of the world, that through their leadership, the whole world will recognize our need of you, and true conversation of heart so that we may become givers of life, builders of communities, and witnesses of your wisdom and love. May the decisions of our leaders be always for the common good and bring us toward unity and peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Mara and Patrick and all married couples. May they learn that love dies without sacrifice. May they persevere in rising above their own needs and live lives of constant forgiveness for each other's failures and shortcomings. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parents, families, and friends of Mara and Patrick, who have guided and supported them all these years, may they continue to inspire them to make Jesus Christ the center of their life together through a life of prayer that flows into action, especially for the needy and the disadvantaged. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone ahead of us, especially Mara's grandfathers, Onofre B. Banson and Jose Maria Zaragoza, Patrick's grandfathers, Krause Ignacio and Josing Reyes, and Patrick's grandmother, Natividad Reyes, may they remain with us in spirit and live in God's peace. May they intercede for the newlywed couple, Mara and Patrick, so that God may guide them in their own journey to God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father,
This veil is a symbol of the faithful and everlasting love the bride and groom have for each other. It also symbolizes the unity of two families into one.
No.
This cord symbolizes the love and friendship that bind the couple together, and the figure eight shape represents the infinite nature of matrimony.
Show favor to our supplications, O Lord, and receive with a kindly countenance the oblations. We offer for these your servants, Mara and Patrick, now joined in a holy covenant. Through these mysteries, may they be strengthened in love for one another and for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity, that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity, and so the sacrament of holy matrimony, as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates the love of man and woman through Christ, the bridegroom of the church. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Luis Antonio, our Bishop, Socrates Villegas, also our Bishop here, and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Mara and Patrick, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love in peace. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially Onofre, Jose Maria, Natividad, Kraus, Josing, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray like Jesus. Let us bow down our heads, and in the silence of our hearts, Pray for Mara and Patrick and all their hopes and dreams and plans. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image and will that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants, Mara and Patrick, who are joined today in the sacrament of matrimony. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Mara, and upon Patrick, her companion for life, and may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of matrimony, they may adorn their family with children and enrich the church. In happiness may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly, and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surround them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. This is the Lord, the bridegroom of the church, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. we please request the chord sponsors Rafa and Carla and veil sponsors Gino and Paola to remove the chord and veil.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, Mara and Patrick, and that the effects of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by us all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Mara and Patrick, now that you have received the holy sacrament of matrimony, I admonish you to remain faithful to one another. Alam mo, Patrick, kapag seryoso ako, nagtatagalog ako. Kaya magtatagalog ako. Huwag mong papaiyakin si Mara. Kapag pinaiyak mo si Mara, lagot ka sa akin. Mara, you are intelligent, you are independent-minded, but you must learn to submit to the headship of Patrick. There is only one head in the family, and that is Patrick. You may have a better opinion, you may have a better plan, but because Patrick is head of the family, you must obey. Pag nagreklamo si Patrick sa akin, Mara, Tagalog to, na ina-under mo si Patrick, lagot ka rin sa akin. You must recognize that you are incomplete without the other. And Patrick, Mara can cry when she's happy. Mara can cry when she's sad. Mara can cry when she's in pain. I know it is inevitable. You can cause each other pain. You cannot avoid it. You will hurt each other. But do not discuss who is right or who is wrong. Just say, "Rush, I'm sorry." Mara and Patrick, Ateneo is not the best school. Neither is it La Salle. It is the Christian family. And parents are the first and the best teachers. Soon you will be parents. Please make sure that you set the good example for your children to learn. And if there should come a time when troubles become unbearable, Mara and Patrick, I am here. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord Jesus, who graced the marriage at Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones forever and ever.
Amen.
May he who loved the church to the end unceasingly pour his love into your hearts forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord grant that bearing witness to faith in his resurrection, you may await with joy the blessed hope to come.
Amen.
Father Roch and I will come together to bless you. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have received the love of God. Let us share that love with everybody.
Thanks be to God.
Let us welcome to our Christian community Mr. and Mrs. Patrick and Mara Reyes.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the best wedding, the wedding of the year, Mara and Pat's wedding.
The royal wedding.
The royal wedding, definitely.
Ray-Ban 2015.
Yeah, you can applaud. You can applaud for this wedding. Definitely a big endeavor on their part.
All right, my name is Isabel Daza, but you can call me Belle. I'll be your MC, along with...
My name is Miggy. I'll be your MC as well, and you can call me Miggy if you want.
All right. I've been friends with Mara since we were high school. We're best friends. I also consider her one of my best friends. Actually, I was supposed to be a maid of honor, but I got demoted to hosting. So you guys are going to have to bear with me tonight, and Miggy, of course.
Well, Pat and I have been friends. Well, we've known each other since we were at grade 3. So been through a lot of years together. I've known him since he was a wee little dugyutin boy all the way until now that he's cleaned up pretty well, I would say.
Yes.
Yeah.
Still all right. Should we start to
definitely
introduce our VIP guests at the grand entrance? All right. First up, we have Tita Melly Corazon Diaz. Tita Melly is Mara's mom's best friend who has been there ever since their family has been in sickness and in health. Mara considers Tita Melly her favorite Singapore travel buddy. Mara couldn't have picked a more steadfast prayer warrior and advice giver than Tita Melly.
And with her is Ninong Teria. Teria? Okay. He's our representative from Trondheim, Norway. He is the husband of Tita Isabel, the sister of Patrick's mom. As a Norwegian, Ninong Teria lives up to be a true Viking. As he looks vicious and he loves alcohol. Obviously, he looks so vicious, doesn't he? And as an orthodontist, he loves to correct crooked teeth and crooked children as well. Ninong Teria has been close to Patrick, whom he considers as a big brother and an advisor.
Rita Tolentino and Martin Kimson. Tita Marga is Mara's mom's sister, who has always been Mara's second mother since birth. Though she lives in LA, Tita Marga has always been here for every milestone in Mara's life, and Mara could not have imagined this special day without her.
And this dashing young lad that he is with is Tito Martin. He's been a close family friend of the Bansons since Mara was a child. He and Tita Fina have both been ever present in their lives as guardian angels, helping their family in their times of need. Mara couldn't have picked a more loving couple to help guide them through their marriage. Round of applause for this couple.
Jeanette Zilweta and Arlen De Guzman. Tita Jeanette is one of Mara's mom's four roommates. Growing up, Tita Jeanette was always the sweetest woman who was present in their lives.
While Ninong architect Arlen is known as, obviously, an architect, an interior designer, and a gun collector. Don't mess with this guy. Don't piss him off. I wouldn't. What people do not know is his lean physique. He used to be, get this, a ballet dancer. Yes, a ballet dancer. Architect Allen has been a very... What do you need? A gun-toting ballerina. He's a very close friend of the Reyeses going back to their early working days in Hong Kong.
We have Anna Pastelero and Francisco Tanhuaco. Tita Anna is Mara's dad's sister, who Mara greatly looks up to for her advice on family and life. Tita Anna is one of the pillars that has kept their Banson clan together, a true example of a great mom and wife and a successful career woman who Mara greatly admires.
Ninong Paquito, on the other hand, is one of Patrick's dad's best friends, dating back some 50-something years ago since Ateneo grade school days. He is also Mara's Lola, being the youngest brother of Mara's Lola, Lita. On the fun side, Ninong Paquito is supposed to be an expert dancer. Can we see a little demo of that? Get this, not just any dancer, but a dancer in pole dancing. But that's only in Boracay, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe if we get him drunk enough, we might see some of that action tonight.
All right, thank you. Next up, we have Victoria Joaquin and Roberto Ignacio. Ninang Vicky is the eldest sister of Patrick's mom, and together with her twin brother, Uncle Vico, represent the second set of the Ignacio twins. Patrick grew up together with Ninang Vicky's children, O'Neill, Owen, and Ono. Ninang Vicky is so baby-faced that everybody thinks she's the youngest of the Ignacio girls.
While Ninong Obet is the oldest brother of Patrick's mom, a twin brother of Uncle Ato, and the head of their family business. Another ex-ballet dancer. Now I know where Pat gets his dancing prowess. Ninong Obet, who wears his hair long and is a frustrated Hell's Angel fan, and races his motorcycle and car all over the Philippines. Can we welcome back Liswasho, Likauko, and Francis Sebastian.
Ninong Bak has been a very close family friend of the Reyes family for more than 55 years. She being the better half of Uncle Mito, who is one of Patrick's dad's closest friends, also from Ateneo. Most of you probably do not know that Ninong Bak Likauko taught English at Assumption High School, where she had a reputation for never wearing the same dress twice. Love it. In her free time, she also writes on and for travel in the Philippines tour.
Ninong Francis is also one of Patrick's dad's best friends and a longtime business colleague. Before Ninong Francis became a top banking executive, he graduated with top honors as a scholar from Ateneo. What people do not know is that he did this while spending most of his time watching movies.
Thank you. We should have made them dance at the center.
We will. We definitely will. We have such a lovely display of uncanny ballerinas in the family.
And
apparently,
the last one of the Ninongs and Ninangs is Doris Magsaysay Ho, though Tita Do could not be here. Tita Do has been one of Mara's idols since she was a child. Mara grew up traveling together with the YPO group and would often call herself Tita Do's favorite. Hey, hi Tita Do, if you're watching the video.
I hope you're having fun wherever you are, as much as we are tonight.
And here we go. Let's welcome the parents of the bride. Give it up for Tito Jan B and Tita Godette Batson.
There we go, a little dancing right there won't hurt anyone. Oh, we're not done.
I love the sample.
There we go. And once again, a round of applause for the parents of the bride, Jan B and Ludette Banson.
Without whom Mara would not be here today, literally.
Yeah, amazing. Last but not least, let us all welcome the parents of the groom, Tito Boy Boy and Tita Cater Reyes. Give it up, give it up. 1-2, 1-2.
Yes.
You have to do a little dance. You have to do a little dance. Go. Simply wonderful.
Parents of the groom.
Round of applause again for the parents of the groom, Tita Boy Boy and Tita Kate Reyes.
We're moving on. We have our entourage. Let's welcome the candle sponsors, John Ignacio
and Marian Christina Reyes.
It's like I'm waiting my whole life.
You guys have to dance.
May we call on the Veil sponsors, Jamie Giampaolo Banson
and Paolo Coanco Banson. Let's go, guys! Show us your moves!
It's your time to shine, time to shine. All right, we'll keep it a little for later, yeah.
Paolo had a Can't lot spend of fun in our bachelorette party, right, Paolo?
Maybe, I'm sure we'd all like to hear about that later on.
Now we have our court sponsors, Rafael Angelo Banson
and Carla Ramona Anita Banson.
It's like I've been waiting my whole life for this one night. It's gonna be me when I'm dancing.
Carla was late when she arrived, so she wasn't in the photos a while ago. Binubukin kita. Alright, but it's okay because she cried enough tears that made up for it. Alright, take a bow, guys.
Good job, all right.
Thank you.
Let's now welcome the groomsmen and the bridesmaids.
Now, this has to be fun because, of course, they're the friends. It's, you know, more loose. You guys have to come in dancing. We're going to put you on the spot.
Time to shine, ladies and gentlemen. Time to shine. Let's call on and let's see if these two can set the bar up really high for the other groomsmen and bridesmaids. Let's all welcome Mr. Patrick Santos
and Anna Ojeda.
That's all we get, a little raise the roof, that's it.
Yeah. I don't know why he's being shy.
If any one of you knew who this guy is, you'd be wondering why he's not dancing right now. Not enough alcohol, obviously.
All right, next up we have J.L. Gavino.
And Misha Balangwe. Change the music later on.
Okay.
All right. Let's all welcome Mr. Gabriel Rojas.
And Lourdes Maikez.
Forever, ever, ever, forever, ever, ever, forever, ever, ever, forever,
let's all welcome the showstopper, Mr. Paolo Blasco. Mr. Paolo Blasco, I haven't seen those moves since the 60s. Great, let's hope it stays there. Let's all welcome Mr. Jazz Estrada.
And Raquel Guerrero. Raquel loves to play badminton as a hobby. And she also loves to travel and paint on her spare time. She stands 5'3".
Jazz Estrada stands 5 foot something, and I don't really care. Let's call on Mr. Pio Gutierrez.
And Mara Linera. Mara is a friend of both Pat and Mara. She was with them in Singapore. She stands 5'9", and is single and ready to mingle.
Give it up! Single and ready to mingle. Watch out! The main event of the evening. Let's all welcome Mr. Miggy Villanueva.
That's him. And Isabel Daza.
Bring it up.
No? Okay, I see some people clapping over there.
We'd like to thank our little company of friends for applauding us for that little endeavor. Thank you so much. Feel the love, guys. We feel the love.
Thank you, guys. All right. Best men and maids of honor. Here we go.
Let's welcome Mr. Jose Michael Reyes.
And Margarita Nicole Maliari. Margarita, or Maria, has been Mara's friend since she was in grade school. She is now a mother of an 8-year-old who is so cute, she's going to be an artista when she grows up, right?
That's a guarantee.
Yes, you're going to dance on Sundays in ASAP. Okay.
Didn't see that coming. Okay. Let's all welcome Mr. Jose Victor Reyes.
And Leah Criselda Mangalinda. Leah is also Mara's best friend. She's equally as beautiful and talented. But she's taken, guys. Jacob's over here, her boyfriend. Say hi, Leah.
Last but not least, let's welcome Jose Francis Reyes.
And Maria Victoria Francesca Manson, also known as Kai. She is Mara's youngest sister. Ooh. Hi guys, looking good together. No, I'm just kidding, Tito Lodette is here.
Yeah, totally not awkward at all.
And I just received word that Tito Doris Magsaysay Ho is here. Let's say hi to Tito Doris. Hi!
Tito Doris, where are you? Hello!
You had a dance number here? There
oh, there you go!
And for the main event?
The one that you've all been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Mr. and Mrs. Patrick
and
Mara Reyes.
Come on, guys, stand up!
Put your hands up! Bring it up! Bring it up! Let's make this lovely couple feel the love! A little more applause, ladies and gentlemen!
be shy about.
Something I did not expect Pat Reyes to say, ever.
But right now, we're going to have a little father and daughter dance.
A little intimate moment before the fun.
So take it away, guys.
Cue the music.